Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this is the new Apple Studio Display. This arrived yesterday in the mail, so I thought I'd show you what it looks like when you unbox it from the mail as well. So let's go ahead and pull this pull tab. There we go. And there's the display itself. So it looks like we can lay this down, and then the box just sort of opens up. So looks like it opens up like that. And that's how it comes from the mail. So let's go ahead and take the box itself out, and then we'll take a closer look around it. As you can see, it says Studio Display, and I actually picked up the cheapest one, the $1,599 version. Now, this can come in a couple different configurations, up to $1,899 with the nano texture glass, and then you can also add an additional $400 to get a height adjustable tilt display. So this just has the standard display. It's $1,599. Now let's go ahead and open it up. We'll just pull this little tab here. And let's see what we've got. So we lay it down just like this. This is very similar to an iMac. We'll open it up and you can see it says Studio Display. So Studio Display, you've got some arrows. We'll push out on these. There we go, it opens up. And I guess we just pull out the display like this. So we'll set that aside here. Over there. Let's see what we've got as far as paperwork. So inside here, I guess we've got some paperwork right here. Just says Studio Display, sort of a quick start guide. And then we've got two black Apple stickers. So sort of the pro Apple stickers. And you've just got a couple little things in here talking about warranty and more. Set that down, and you can see it includes a Thunderbolt cable. So these are always nice. You just pull them, no plastic or anything like that. And then this just comes out like that. This is a nice braided Thunderbolt cable as well. So it's braided around the outside edge and then just Thunderbolt. So it's about 3 feet or so, or a meter. And they will offer a longer one later. You do get a longer cable with the Pro Display XDR as well. So the display weighs 13.9 pounds or 6.3 kilograms. Now, if you get the tilt adjustable one, it's 16.9 pounds or 7.7 kilograms. So it's fairly heavy. Now let's go ahead and see if we can remove this cover. So on the back here, I guess we just pull this off. So we'll remove this. See if we can get around it. There we go. And then this just pulls off the top. Then we've got a little backpack on the back. Let's see, we just pull it like this. There we go. And one of the interesting things is this actually doesn't have a detachable power cord. So unlike a lot of Apple's other products, they didn't use MagSafe or anything else. They just gave you this power cord, which is attached. Now it is nice and braided. So as you can see, it's the typical braided cord, but it's not detachable. So as you can see, you can't remove it. And then of course we have our ports. We have a Thunderbolt port and then three USB-C. On the bottom, before we take the cover off the screen, we just have a vent across the entire bottom where it actually is for probably ventilation as well as the speakers that are internal. So we've got a tilt adjustable display. So it's tilt adjustable. And you could have the height adjustable one, but I normally put this on a monitor stand anyway. Let's take off the front panel here, or the front plastic, and see what we've got. And there we go. Now you can see it's a glossy display, and I didn't go for the matte or nano texture finish because I actually like the glossy display as long as you don't have windows behind you. So I don't have any windows behind me. In fact, they're in front of me. And this is actually a 27-inch display. So 5K Retina display, 5120 by 2880 at 218 pixels per inch. It goes up to 600 nits of brightness, up to 1 billion colors, wide color P3, and has True Tone, but not HDR. It also has a bunch of reference modes we'll take a look at when we connect it. And then of course we have our webcam here at the top. Now it's a 12 megapixel camera with a field of view of 122 degrees. It's an f2.4 aperture and supports center stage. Now, obviously if you've seen some of the other reviews, people have been saying that it's not that great. So we'll check that out in a moment, but Apple is saying that they're going to update this as well. One other thing I wanted to mention is compatibility. So whether you have an iPad Pro like this one, or maybe another iPad, there is some compatible iPads, but it starts with the iPad Air 5th generation that just came out, also the iPad Pro 11-inch and iPad Pro 12.9 third generation or later. That's what's supported as far as iPads. When it comes to Macs, you can see them here. So basically from 2017 and later, depending on the Mac. So iMac Pro 2017, 2017 or later, 21.5 inch iMac and so on. And then of course the Mac Pros, and then 13 inch MacBook Pro 2016 and later, and 15 inch 2016 and later. So the iPads kind of lose out here a bit, but for the most part, it should be pretty good. Let me go ahead and plug this in and we'll take a look at it. Now, the first thing I wanted to try is the iPad Air 5th Gen. Since it's supported, I'm on the latest version. Let's go ahead and plug it in and see what happens. It does say that it's supported. It made a sound. Let me rotate it here. And you can see it does not fill the entire screen, but it actually works just like you would expect. So it does work with that. Maybe if we go into the webcam, let's do that. Spin it around, and it's actually showing the webcam from the iPad. So if I put my thumb over it, you can see that. So it doesn't use the webcam from the studio display. And if we go home, of course, you can just use your iPad like this. Now also, if we maybe play sound through it, let's see what that sounds like. So I brought up my YouTube video about this iPad Air, and the sound comes through the speakers of the studio display. So if I hit play,
this is the iPad Air. Here I have the brand new blue color, but we also have a few other color options, space gray, pink, purple, and starlight.
So it does work just like you would expect that way, but the webcam doesn't go through the iPad. Now let's plug in a MacBook. So here I have the 14-inch MacBook Pro, the latest version. Let's go ahead and plug it in just like that. And let's push it back here just a little bit, and then I'll get my keyboard and mouse. We have the studio display connected to the MacBook Pro, and it works seamlessly like you would expect. So we can use the brightness keys on the keyboard to go up and down, up to 600 nits of brightness, and it's actually plenty bright, but doesn't have HDR modes. So if we turn this down a little bit, you'll see what it looks like there. And then also we have volume control as well. So it's always nice to have that directly from your keyboard and integrated directly into your display. Now, if we go into the system preferences, there should be some display modes as well. So if we go to displays, and then under displays, you'll see it says studio display and what it's connected to. And then of course we have scaled here, so we can change the scale. And then also we have some presets. So you can see all the different presets here from the P3 to 600 nits, to digital cinema, photography, internet and web. And of course you can customize those as well to whatever you'd like. We do have True Tone. I tend to turn that off because I want it to look true to life, not the white of what the ambient light sensor is picking up. But in general, it looks great as far as that goes. And of course, now we have universal control where we can use that with an iPad as well. So you can adjust this to whatever you'd like. And of course, automatically adjust brightness if you'd like as well. But no HDR modes, unfortunately. So let's see if we can watch an HDR video. And then also, let's take a listen to the speakers. And so as you can see here, I have one of my HDR videos. So if we click on HDR, we actually have the option for 2160p HDR. So you can watch HDR, it just won't be in its full brightness necessarily that you get with, say, an iPhone or one of the latest iPads Pro or Pro Display XDR. Now also, let's take a listen to the speakers since many people are saying they're quite good. So here is one of my comparison videos I did, just showing the XR versus the 11. So take a listen to the speakers during the sort of photo montage or comparison. The speakers sound surprisingly good. They're quite loud and I'm pretty impressed by them. They're definitely the best speakers of any display that Apple has made. So it has 6 speakers internally and sounds really great. Now, of course, there's the webcam. We need to take a look at that and see what that looks like as well. Now, here is the webcam with center stage. So if I move over here, it will follow me around. And if someone walks into the frame, it will zoom out so you can see everybody. So it works pretty well. I've been using center stage for a while with the iPad Pro, and finally it's on a Mac, or at least a Mac display anyway, and this is great to have. So this is something I really appreciate them adding, but as far as the quality of the webcam, well, it actually looks okay. It's not amazing, but I wanted to have you see and hear what it sounds like as well. So let me switch to something where I can record it. So here's the camera from the studio display. Now I expect the microphones to sound great, and of course let me know what you think about them in the comments below, but typically they've done a great job on the MacBooks and more with their studio mics within the different products that they have, so the display and the MacBook and more. But this webcam does not look great. It's actually very grainy, and we're on maximum recording settings, so it should be the highest quality possible right now. Now, Apple did say they're going to update this a little bit later and fix this, and I expect they can do that since we have better quality from a same megapixel camera on an iPhone. So I would expect them to do that, but right now it doesn't look great. Hopefully they'll fix this pretty quickly with an update. And the studio display is said to be running iOS 15.4 or some version of it since it's using the A13 Bionic. So they definitely could just push an update, and hopefully we'll see that very soon. The studio display is 27 inches where the Pro display is 32. This gives you an idea of size difference with real estate between both of them. So you have the same size window. I opened it on the studio display, opened a new one, and just dragged it over to the Pro display. So you definitely get some more real estate as far as the overall display goes. Of course, it's 6K versus 5K as well, so it's a little bit nicer as far as that part goes, and the studio display looks good, but the Pro display is leaps better and should be for its cost. Now, both of these are 60 Hertz, and there's some complaints about this as well. So scrolling is nice and smooth. It's what you would expect on these displays. The same is true for the Pro Display XDR, 60 Hertz. So we don't have 120 Hertz refresh rate or anything like that. I expect Apple will release maybe an updated Pro Display XDR with that sort of feature with maybe 120 Hertz. However, if you're editing video or photos, that doesn't make too much of a difference as we're typically editing at 2430 or 60 frames per second. So most people don't even do 60 frames, most are in 2430. So for editing video like that, it really makes no difference whatsoever. But if you were to play games, of course, or just scrolling in general, it definitely makes a difference. So that's something that we haven't seen. It's a little bit disappointing, but maybe we'll see that in future revisions. But for the price, it's something I would have hoped they'd included, as well as maybe a little bit brighter, but maybe we'll see that in future revisions. Now with the lights dimmed, you can see that the studio display has sort of a light gray background. I have the same background on the Pro Display XDR. It just looks like it's turned off until I drag my mouse over here. So you can see local dimming zones as it follows the mouse cursor around. But other than that, it looks completely dark or black. And as we go over to the studio display, it looks a little bit more of a light gray. Now, I don't see a lot of bleed around the outside edges as far as light getting through, so it looks like it's built pretty well, maybe a little bit down in the bottom left, but in general, it's what you would expect with basically the LG 5K display as well. And here's another example, another wallpaper or black background I created that shows the difference between both displays. So again, a light gray background on the studio display, the Pro Display XDR, is completely dark with the exception of right around the edges of the line that I created here and of course the circles as well. So that gives you an idea of the difference between both displays. One quick thing to note is that the polishing cloth was not in the box with my studio display. I noticed it was in some other unboxings and I think that's because they had the nano texture display. So I'm thinking it doesn't come with the base one. This is actually from the Pro Display XDR. So it looks like with the base model, if you need that cloth, you can buy it separately, but it doesn't come with the base model at least. So if you did get it, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Now, I've been thinking for the past few days while I was waiting for the studio display, who this is really for and why are so many people frustrated by this? No, it doesn't have 60 Hertz. No, it's not 1,000 nits, but it has some great benefits. The 5K Ultrafine is $300 less expensive than the base model of this one. But the build quality is terrible, at least in my experience. I used one. In fact, I had two of them. I returned them because I didn't like the way they looked. They were buggy, and I just decided they weren't for me. So I ended up getting something else, an ultra wide at that time. And they just weren't for me. They looked okay, and the display here looks great, but the build was terrible. This has great speakers, it's seamless, it just plugs in and it works. So that's enough for me to upgrade from that to this model. You get Apple's sort of uniformity and just simplicity. You've got speakers and more, but it's an expensive display. So it's not for everyone, it's for someone that wants a seamless experience. You plug it in, it charges your Mac, and you're good to go. Otherwise, there's other options out there. In this video, you may have already seen a monitor in the background when I was testing out the webcam. That's a 1,000 nit monitor that can do 144 hertz. So you can use it for gaming and it goes super bright, but it's not plug and play and it's not seamless and you can't control it from your keyboard as far as brightness and sound. So there's benefits back and forth and what matters most to you. I think a lot of people with Mac Studio will be happy with the display, and if they want, they can step up to a Pro Display XDR. There's lots of options out there though, if that's not what you like. If you don't care about the design, well then there's plenty of other options. If you care about all the things I've already mentioned, well then the Studio display's for you. I think it's that simple. So if you want one, pick one up. I think they're great. I'll be using it in a different studio. I use my Pro Display XDR here. I'll use that one where I was using a BenQ monitor before, where it was just a bit of a pain. The brightness wasn't right, and it wasn't 100% as accurate as far as adjusting it all the time. It was just a little bit of a pain for me compared to this, where it's just more simple. So I'm used to this. It's what I like, it's what I'll use. But again, there's a ton of different options out there. So I'd love to hear what you think about the Studio display. Are you picking one up? What do you think about it as far as value and more? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.